friends, welcome to Welding Inspection. Today we are going to look about the CC Welding Inspector Level 2 course. And the topics which are included in this program, we will going to look about the overview, what is CC Inspector, and the examination pattern in this video. So first we will going to look about the welding CCP inspector. What are the contents in this exam? Okay, totally we have 23 topics. First one was typical duties of welding inspector, and second was terms and definition, and also having a subtopics of types of weld, types of joints, weld preparation, size of butt welds, etc. Then the next topic was, third one is welding inspection and material inspection. In this we have a definition, cracks, cavities, solid inclusion, lack of fusion and penetration, etc. We have in this topic. And fourth one was destructive testing. Fifth one was non-destructive testing. In this we will having a fourth chapter, which is radiography, ultrasonic methods, magnetic particle testing and dye penetration. So in this non-destructive testing we have only the four methods of NDT in this program. Then the next sixth one was WPS, welder qualification. In this we will going to about the look about welding procedure specification, welder qualification. And seventh was material inspection. In this we will going to look about the material type and its weldability, alloying elements and their effects, material traceability and its summary. Okay. Eighth one was codes and standard. In this what is the code and difference between codes and standard we will going to look about. And also we have each section summary about the each topic. Ninth one was welding symbols. In this we have dimension of welds, supplementary symbols, dimension and position of welding, like etc. We will going to look about in this chapter. 10th one was introduction to welding inspection, welding process. In this chapter we will going to look about the heat input, welding parameters, productivity and the process which are included in this program. We are having four process in this program. And also we will look about how to calculate heat input, what are the parameters have to look about for each welding process, and power source and characteristics. In this CCP exam we have four welding processes, which is SMAW, TIG welding, MIG and MAC welding, and another one was SCW welding, submerged arc welding. So please don't worry about the welding processes. We will only going to look about the four welding processes in this exam. 11th one was MMA SMAW welding, which is manual metal arc or shield metal arc welding. In this we will going to look about the equipment requirements, power requirements, welding variables. In TIG, 12th was TIG welding. In this we will going to look about the equipment requirements, filler wire, tungsten inclusion and its advantages and disadvantages of tungsten in net gas welding. 13th one was MIG and MAC welding. In this we will going to look about the process, variables, equipment requirements, how to inspect the MIG and MAC welding, power characteristics, and also we will going to look about flux code arc welding and its summary of solid wire MIG MAC welding. 14th chapter was submerged arc welding. In this also we will going to look about the storage and care of welding consumables, power sources which is required in for SAW. And 15th was thermal cutting processes. We will have a four thermal cutting processes: oxy fuel cutting, plasma arc cutting, arc gear couching, manual metal arc couching.
we will going to look about this.
And also we will going to look about, I will make a further upcoming videos for each topic, one video. I am planning to do that.
And who are interested to do a CC building inspector course, please subscribe my channel and click the bell button. And also who are working in this sector, like a welding QC inspector, they can also subscribe to my channel, then they will get a recall from my video. 16th was welding consumables. In this we will going to look about consumables, storage condition, what are the consumables used in TIG, MIG, MAC welding, and also going to look about AWS A5.1 and AWS 5.5, what the codes and standards says. 17th then was weldability of steel. In this we will going to look about what is weldability, factors that affect weldability, and how do we consider the materials weldability, and hydrogen cracking, solidification cracking, what are the alloying elements in this material can build, and weld decay, what is weld decay in details, and what is weld decay. 18th was weld repairs. In this we will going to look about two specific areas in weld repair. 19th was residual stress and destruction. In PWHT, what is residual stress and destruction? What causes the destruction? What is the main factor of destruction? And types, prevention by design, how to prevent the destruction using design, and also how to correct the corrective techniques. 20 was heat treatment. In this we will going to look about heat treatment of steel, post weld heat treatment, pre-heat treatment, and PWHT thermal cycle, and also why the heat treatment is required for welding, and what are the benefits while doing heat treatment. In detail we will going to look about in this chapter. 21 was arc welding safety. In this we will going to look about how to ensure our safety with the electric shock and heat and light while welding. Fumes, gases will be come from the welding with the flux. How to choose the flux, and noise, how to reduction the noise, and its summary in detail. Now also we will going to look about the electrical characteristics, up to what electrical characteristics, what ampere voltage can be used, etc. in this arc welding safety. Also the proper PPE, etc. in this summary. 22nd was calibration. We will what is terminology during calibration, calibration frequency, instrumentation for calibration, calibration methods. In this chapter we will going to look about the calibration in detail. 23rd was application and control of preheat. 23rd was application and control of preheat. In this we will going to look about what is preheat and control of preheat and interface temperature in detail. I hope this video will help you about the contents which are included in CC. So please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and further video will be uploaded, so please click the bell button. Thank you.